Hey everyone, CW Music Reviews here. I'm CWD and this is going to be a music review of the new Deacon album, Sleep Cycle. Deacon is a multi-instrumentalist, singer-songwriter, as well as one of the members of Animal Collective, or he used to be anyway, I don't know what's going on with that. And this is his debut full-length album. This album in particular has some history about it. It started out as a Kickstarter around 2009 where Deacon needed funds to go do this festival in Africa. Then he was going to make an album. And then he was going to donate the good chunk of the rest to charity. I don't know if he was able to do the festival or not. I think he did. But pretty much he just ended up donating what was left to charity and self-funded making this album. But 2 out of 3 ain't that bad, I guess. I'm not sure what's going on with Deacon in terms of, like, his relationship with Animal Collective. I know that he was absent for the making of their latest record, Painting With, an album that I reviewed on this channel. Check it out. I thought it was particularly good, one of my favorites of February. So, on that note, Deacon is on his own right now and has this new album out called Sleep Cycle. It came out this month, so I thought I'd just put it on my to-do list to review, and here I am reviewing it. So what has the Deekster bestowed upon us? I think Deacon bestowed upon us a particularly good record. Not a fantastic record, or even a great record, but a good record. This album is about 6 tracks in length, about 33, 34 minutes in length. So it's brief, but the songs are not by any means brief. Which leads me to my big complaint. I really do wish that either this album had more tracks, or it fleshed out the tracks it already had to more progressive lengths. I think Deacon's got something going for him in terms of having a solo career. Take the opening track, for example, Golden Chords. It's this nice, kind of dark and cacophonous acoustic track. There's some light percussion going on in the background, whilst there's all these effects that resemble a babbling creek, the moon hanging overhead. It's a nice and pleasant opener. It really sets the tone for a well-varied record. Deacon sings particularly well in this track and pretty much every track here with vocals. There's some little slight reverb on this track, whereas Animal Collective now have completely done away with reverb. But anyway, yeah, this album. We get to the next track, Just Am, which I initially liked a lot. It's got a old school Animal Collective sound to it. It's a pretty bright instrumental. There's a looped and wavy synth going on, as well as some fluttering piano that comes up in the track. I do have a complaint about certain moments in the track where I guess we're reaching the refrain, where all these effects and instrumentation just builds into this one overbearing wall of sound that really gets kind of difficult to listen to after so many times. So that's kind of led me to like it a little less over time. Not so much that I think it's a bad track or anything like that, but it's still a difficult piece to trudge through. We get the track Shadow Mind, which feels just like a continuation of the previous track. It's pretty fillerish, which is really disappointing given that there's only 6 tracks to this record. But then we get to my favorite track on the album, Footy. Footy is pretty much the main reason why I'm reviewing this record. It starts out with Deacon having these really eccentric vocal delivery before you get this interloping guitar and drum syncopation that just is really hard-hitting. It's really immediate. I certainly enjoy it a lot. This instrumental actually gets kind of progressive in that it's throwing in lots of variation within the 7 minutes this track runs for. It kind of reminds me of a track off of Meriwether Post Pavilion if Deacon was allowed to, I guess, put another song in there. I think it actually would have fit snugly in that album, given how lavish and just hard-hitting it is. It certainly holds my attention from beginning to end. Probably the best one in the whole record. Then we get to another filler track, Seed Song. Not sure where the track was going with it. Once again, repeating this cacophonous and creak babbling sound that was on opening track, Golden Chords. I guess if there's one thing I can notice about this track is that the title of this album is Sleep Cycle. It does remind me of the cycles of dreaming. Get something soft and then eventually it goes into a lot of vivid and really in-your-face moments before it goes back into a more soft and kind of indistinct feel before it repeats itself again, or eventually you just wake up. And the closing track, Good House, glides pretty well from Seed Song, but I can't say it's a favorite of mine in the track listing. It's got some looped percussion and just maintains the atmospheric vibe that the previous track was trying to go for, and I think it does that particularly well. There's some slight build to it, but I can't say that there was a whole lot to this track that really grabbed my attention, aside from Deacon singing pretty well. So overall, I do enjoy this album. I think it's got plenty going for it. I just don't believe that this is a record that I want Deacon to be remembered for. Well, I do like over half of the compositions on this album a lot. I can't say that this could have been anything more than just an EP. If you just shredded Seed Song and Shadow Mind, you could have easily gotten a really great EP instead of just a nice album. It's got plenty going for it. I do like this album quite a bit. I just don't particularly love it. If you invested in this Kickstarter and you've been waiting on Deacon to drop something, I do think he delivers. I don't think he delivers fantastically, but he certainly delivers on this. This album is a plus 1.6 out of plus 3. If you're into neo-psychedelia music, then you'll definitely want to check this out. You might like it a little more than me. And if you're already into Animal Collective and wanted to see what Deacon is up to, then check this out. You won't be disappointed. But if you give this album a listen, what'd you think of it? Did you like this album? Did you dislike this album? What was your reasoning for that? And what should I consider listening to and reviewing next? CWD Music Reviews here, signing off.